Hey, it's Ben here, and in this very quick tutorial, we're going to have a look at how we manage the duration of multiple transitions in one go in Final Cut Pro 10. So the first thing I'm going to do is just add some transitions onto my timeline here. And to do this, I'm just going to drag across a few clips. I'm going to come to my transitions across here, and we're going to use basic dissolve transitions and double click on the cross dissolve. And that will add our default transition. Now, we can select a transition here and extend it out, and we can do that for all our different transitions. But if we want to set them all to the same length, then there's a nice quick way of doing that, and that's by using the command shortcut key when we actually select these clips. I'm going to hold down command and just click on all these, so now with all those transitions selected, I can hold down control and tap D. And now I can type in a duration for those transitions. So if I want them to be nice and super quick, then I can tap 5, hit enter, and that will make them all exactly 5 frames long. So you can see they're now super short. If I want them to be a bit longer, then I'll hold down control and tap D again, and then I'll type in 5 period, and the period is going to make it say 5 seconds up here in the middle for the duration. Hit enter, and now all those transitions are at 5 seconds, or as long as they can be. Obviously that looks a little bit too long, so I'm going to do control and D and type in 1.15, so 1.5 seconds with this 30 frames per second clip will make them all 1.5 seconds long. So you can see by using the command key to quickly select those transitions, we can change multiple transitions all in the same go. Now if you have a much longer timeline where you don't see all your transitions, so we'll just delete those for the moment. I'm going to do Shift and Z, and we're just going to add transitions to all of this. We'll create the transitions, and I'm going to zoom in at the beginning. Now, if I don't want to zoom out and then kind of select them all, perhaps there's a lot of them from the tens to the hundreds, then I can select them all in the index up here at the top left. So essentially what I'm going to do, and this works because they're all cross dissolves, is I'm going to type in cross here. That's going to select in my clips those transitions by name. I can hold down Shift in here, select them all. And the key here is to come back to the timeline and just click to move the playhead a little bit. And now I can do Control and D, and I can type in 2.10, so 2 seconds and 10 frames. And that is going to change the duration of all of those transitions all in one go. So you can see now, using the index, I can change all those transitions in one go and continue to kind of type in different durations as I experiment with things and get the timing of my edit just right, but doing things en masse. What you will notice is that this transition here at the end is not changing, basically because there's not enough media overlapping those two clips to actually make that change. So one last thing we can cover here is if we need to shorten those clips, we can just use these two little double bars at either side to drag and shorten the clips either side, and then we'll be able to extend out that transition as well. So if you're getting transitions that you can't extend, then by using these bars we can do a little ripple edit, and then the change of transition duration will work perfectly. So we'll hit this, come back to our timeline, hold down control and tap D, and we'll do 1.25, and again it's going to change the duration of all of those all in one go. So hopefully that's useful. If you're wanting to change multiple transitions all in one go, perhaps you're doing something like a slideshow where you've got multiple images, then this technique will be really useful for you in those situations. Now, if you have any questions, this particular tutorial came from a question I was asked today, then do leave them in the comments below, and I look forward to seeing you on the next tutorial.